welcome to the Douglas County Chamber's Greystone Power Luncheon. I am Roscoe Sayar with Sam and Roscoe's Restaurant and the Center at Arbor Connection. Also an alumni of Leadership Douglas, class of 2013. It is my great pleasure to introduce today's sponsor and a member of Chamber's Chairman Club, Mr. Gary Lahr with Google. Gary?
Thank you, Roscoe. Thanks to the Douglasville Leadership Group. It looks like you guys have a good presentation scheduled today. I just wanted to take a little bit of your time today to just kind of chat about an upcoming event that we have scheduled for October. Last year, for those of you who were around and knew about this, we did gravity games in the city of Douglasville. And this year, I want to announce that we're going to do it again on October 24th. So last year, we had a really good event. Thank you. Last year, we had a really good event. We had roughly 1,000 people show up to participate and spectate the gravity games themselves. And we expect a pretty good turnout this year. We've got several returning cars coming to the games in the school systems, the police department, the sheriff's department, the fire department, and a couple Google cars as well. So we also have some schools that want to race this year that I wanted to mention. We're looking for companies to sponsor some of these teams. I don't recall the exact price of getting a car for a team, but it's somewhere around $600. These schools really just need help getting one of these cars to build it so they can participate in the race. Bill Arp Elementary School, sorry, I don't have my glasses. Arbor Station Elementary, Mason Creek just got a car, so they might need some help with some hands building it. Eastside Elementary, Bright Star Elementary, North Douglas Elementary, Chapel Hill Middle School, Turner Middle School, Stewart Middle School, Alexander High, and Lithia Springs High School wants to do a complete custom car, which is building a car without a kit. So they would build it from the ground up, and they could use some sponsorship there. If you guys are interested in sponsoring any of these schools, see myself or anybody at the Google table, and we'll hook you up with an email contact at the school that you can work with to sponsor a car for them. So that's really all I wanted to say, and thanks, and congratulations to all the Leadership Douglasville graduates today.
Thank you, Gary. We are delighted to be hosting the graduation of the Leadership Douglas class of 2015 today. And I know our speaker will inspire each of us to re-engage in the service to our community. In order to be respectful of your time, we have shortened the introductions, and we will depend on each of you to read the PowerPoint right behind me for announcements. I would like, however, to recognize our elected officials that are in the room. Would you please stand up and introduce yourselves? Mr. Mayor?
Harvey Persons, Mayor of the City of Douglasville.
Carol Lindstrom, Board of Education.
Tom Martin, Chairman of Board of
Education. Thank you. At this time, I would like to invite one of our Leadership Douglas 2015 graduates, John Pinson, with Douglasville First United Methodist Church, to come forward for the invocation, followed by Pledge of Allegiance.
Thank you, Roscoe. Let us stand, please. Almighty God, we call upon you now to come and be a part of this gathering this day, as well as being part of this community. Guide and direct us, Lord, as we know we need your help and support to make the day-to-day decisions that we need in this time. Thank you for the opportunity of this group and the Chamber of Commerce. And so, Lord, bless us and renew our faith in you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Will you join me in the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, John. Now it is my pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker today. As an LD alumni from 1992, this gentleman has had many years to reflect on leadership. Even more so because he is part of a company that is well known for their leadership training, Chick-fil-A. Mike Moore started with Chick-fil-A in 1985 in Slidell, Louisiana, in North Shore Square Mall. In March of 1989, he had the opportunity to open a freestanding building on Highway 5. 6 years later, in April of 2005, Mike opened up the Fairburn Road, the Chick-fil-A drive-thru. Mike originally grew up in Fairburn, Georgia, and has been married to Judy for 31 years. They have two sons, Michael Paul, 28, and Dustin, 25. And his grandson, Koo, is 14 months old. We appreciate Mike being here today, and we look forward to hearing a few of his leadership lessons. Mike?
Wow. It's changed a little bit since 1992 when I graduated. Much nicer building. And about, 7 or 8 times as many people? So, anyway, today I'd just like to talk to you a little bit about leadership and what is your picture of leadership. And today, I'm preaching to the choir here. We're desperate need of great leaders. You know, I don't care whether we're talking about in your family. I don't care if we're talking about in church. I don't care if we're talking about in government. I don't care if you're talking about at work. We just need great leaders. Leadership is something that we just desperately need, and I hope today that I can bring to light something that will help you on your leadership journey to grow or to help someone else grow and be a better leader. So as we think about what we picture leadership to be, one of my favorite pictures of leadership is just an iceberg. You think about what an iceberg is. It basically has 10 to 20% of it above the water and 80% below the water. And when we're looking for great leaders at Chick-fil-A or looking for great leaders to run restaurants or whatever we need in life, I think about character, okay? If I could have one thing in a leader, it would be a person with character. I can teach them skills. It's not that hard, but if the person will always do the right thing, then we will have leaders that will make mistakes, which is okay. We don't mind that a bit. Of course, you probably don't like it if we give you the wrong Chick-fil-A sandwich with no pickle or give you a Diet Coke instead of a regular Coke. You're not going to like that. But as long as we're doing the right thing when it comes to character, we're dealing with our guests and our employees, then they're doing the right thing. And that's kind of the picture that I like. And I hope that as we go through this, I can paint a picture for you that'll help you become the leader that you need to be. The other part of leadership, the picture that I like to think about, and it's probably one of my favorite too, is the heart. You know, if leaders will lead with their hearts, they're going to do the right thing. When you think about hearts, at Chick-fil-A, we have a lot of acronyms for things. In heart, H-E-A-R-T is what we're going to talk about. The first thing would be hunger for wisdom. Leaders understand the importance of their decisions, countless decisions, people decision, strategy decisions, resource allocations, decisions, they all matter. Wisdom informs us of our decisions, the good news. Wisdom can be forged over time. That's why leaders need to always have knowledge and wisdom One of my favorite statements to my leaders is, if you stop learning, you stop leading. And I think you can take that in case anywhere. Because as leaders that really care, we're going to have to continue to learn. We're going to have to continue to grow. Another important part is expect the best. Leaders are optimistic. They expect the best from themselves and others. They anticipate good outcomes. They believe in the potential of others. This informs all their decisions. However, it's not that you want to look through rose-colored glasses, but great leaders remain grounded in reality and yet still see a future that's better than today. You know, you look at our journey at Chick-fil-A, we would have never dreamed we are today. I mean, when we first built that restaurant in 89, and that was March of 89, 25 years ago, and if we'd had Mr. Caffey and had the few people that were working in the freestanding program, and by the way, that was the 10th freestander ever built in the whole chain. If we were sitting at a table, which you could have set at two tables this size and had the whole group, we would have never dreamed we are today. So if we always try to expect the best at what we do, it's kind of like Mr. Caffey used to say, we're going to build a small company large one step at a time. So if you think about that, expecting the best and leading with your heart, I think it'll help you grow whatever business or whatever leadership position you have. The other thing is accountability. Always accept responsibility. Leaders, at least the best ones, don't blame others. They own their outcomes and the work of those they lead. If it happens on their watch, they own it. At the same time, when things go well, these same leaders are quick to give praise. Leaders possess a wonderful blend of responsibility and humility. And that's another trait that I really like to see in my leadership is humility. Because if we're humble with where we've come from and where we're going, we'll be successful. Kind of reminds me of the servant leadership, which we all know who is the best one at that. Jesus Christ. So he's a great servant leader to keep in mind when you think accountability and humility. R, respond with courage. Leaders take action, they take initiative, and this requires courage. It's not easy to go out and fire that employee that you've had for 15, 20 years. It's not easy to decide that we can't really spend the money on that project or we can't hire that group of people. But as a leader, you have to take that courage. And it's not fun. It's probably the most unfun thing that leaders we have to do on a day out and day basis is with our people and with budgets. But we have to show courage. This often involves unpopular decisions, and leaders accept part of this role. And their first accountability is to the mission or values of that organization. One of the best things that we did at Chick-fil-A is our mission statement. And one of the best things that I have done in my business is to have a mission statement that's similar and have values that are similar. And those four values and mission is what we go by when we make any kind of decision. I don't care if we're filtering it about people. I don't care if we're filtering it about whether we're spending money on items or whatever we're doing. If we use those, stick to those values, it'll help us make great decisions. The T in heart. And this is probably one of the really important one as well. Think others first. This is probably the most critical leadership character trait of them all. The question reflects your leadership character and mine. Are you a serving leader or a self-serving leader? When you and I cultivate the habit of thinking others first in the face and lives of daily challenges, we're well on our way developing the heart of a leader. You might ask, well, why does this even matter? If you and I don't demonstrate these leadership characteristics and traits, we will not be seen as leaders. You may be thinking, I have great skills. I'm the best person at what I do, whatever the job is, whatever the job skills are. But the plain truth about leadership is still skills, your skills and mine, if your heart's not right, nobody's going to care. How many times have you been around leaders and that you knew the people under them didn't even care about them? They didn't care what they did. They didn't care what they said, went in one ear, out the other. So we have to always show people that we care. And that's why I think that as you think about your leadership picture, whatever that is in your mind, if you put it with character and you put it with heart, you'll be able to be successful. Now, it's not easy. It's something you have to work at either as a leader. We have to work at it as a minimum a couple of times a week. We really should. Because if we're not sharpening our skills and getting better at what we do, we're going to get left behind. You know today's technology. I mean, look at what a cell phone can do today. Think about what a cell phone could do 10 years ago. One of my favorite things to tell when I'm speaking to high schools or colleges is tell the kids, how many here play video games? Of course, they all raise their hands, right? Okay. And you say, okay, let's think about video games you played 5 years ago. It's freshmen in high school. These are seniors in high school I'm usually talking to. Okay, think about the video games you play today. Okay, you want to really think about something? Let's think about the video games you're going to be playing when you're a senior in college. What are they going to be like? Okay, technology's changing things. It even changes how much the way we sell chicken. Okay, you would think in the Chick-fil-A business selling chicken, it doesn't change it. Well, it does. I mean, payroll that used to take me hours to do for employees, I can push two or three buttons, it's done in literally seconds. Okay, inventory. We're not there yet, but we're almost to where when a case comes in, we'll know it, we'll barcode it, come out, we'll know it, we sell it. We'll have inventory, instant inventory counts. Just getting along with customers. I mean, think of our new thing that we're doing out in drive-thru, face-to-face. Y'all seen that, where we've got the girls or the guys out there, and they've got the iPads, and they're taking your order. Of course, that's to help increase the line. Bottom line, we're trying to make more money. I apologize. But we also are trying to get orders right. I mean, here, who doesn't like talking to a speaker? I don't. I'd seen talk to a person. So, wow. Sorry about that. Oh, could you tell I'm a golfer? I'm sorry. But anyway, technology, ladies and gentlemen, is just going at an incredible pace. And please continue to learn about technology. It kind of brings me to my last point about change. And it's something I personally had to go through about 4 or 5 years ago in the business world. And you really, if you get stuck in a rut, it's tough to get out. Especially people, I'm going to say of my age, okay? I'll be 55 this year. You know, you get in a habit of doing stuff. Please be willing to change. I mean, think about it when you think about your family members, when you think about people at church, when you think about people in the community or in your business, and you as a young person or even a person that just got a great idea, and they won't ever change. It's frustrating, isn't it? To me personally, it is. But to go through that change takes a lot of soul searching, a lot of time that you have to work on your leadership skills, and you'll be better. I promise you. It's tough, but the more you do and the more you change, the better you'll be as a leader, the better you'll be as a father, the better you'll be as a husband or a wife or a mom or whatever your leadership role is. You know, when we talk about leadership, we're not just talking about business. We're talking about life, okay? And that's what we all want to be as good life leaders, right? And that's what the bottom line is. If we lead our lives correctly, we'll be successful. You know, success isn't about how much money you make. It's about being happy with who you are and what you do. And that's something that I try to stress, especially to the younger people I talk to. But sometimes we adults need to hear that as well. So let's remember that your picture of your leadership, either whether it be iceberg or whatever you picture, is about character. Lead with your heart. And if you're willing to change, you'll be a successful leader, because leaders that don't change won't lead long. You'll lead for a while, but you'll look back and you'll be the only one in line, okay? And it happens, you know? It happens to us all. We just got to continue to grow and get better at what we do and continue to grow as we go through life. Anytime I speak, I always like to ask, there's always some questions that people have about Chick-fil-A, so if there's any questions you have about Chick-fil-A, or anything at all?
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
And you guys have cornered this in customer service. Instead of them saying you're welcome, they're, and I know everybody thinks you're welcome, but I have adopted that in my customer service skills, and it has worked wonders. These things that you make someone feel like they're the only one that is being served at a particular term. Who developed that? Was it true?
Oh, yes, ma'am. You're dead on. You're spot on. It was true with Kathy, and that was him. And I'll tell you how long it took him to do that. We have every year a seminar in February where we go as a group. And we, all the franchisees, all our wives, all the home office staff and wives, and it's kind of just like a family get together, visit, business, social. And we always go to a night resort. Well, it took him 4 years to get us to do that. He asked us the first year to do it. Then he was a little more adamant the second year. And by the third year, a lot of franchisees had bought in and were doing it. And then by the fourth year, we finally pretty much heard it chain-wide. So it took us that way. And I was one of those people that wasn't all happy about it. I thought it was kind of corny. But I will tell you that, talking about chain, once we bought in and once my people bought in, it's the best thing we've ever done. I think it's helping change young people's lives. And of course, when we talk about change, we talk about leading. If we can lead and change young people, that's the best thing we can do, ladies and gentlemen, is if we go out there and we help these young people be successful, grow up and do the right thing. So, yes, Mr. Truett Cathy was the original one, and it took a long time. In fact, even Mr. Collins, Jimmy Collins, who used to be our president, he wasn't real happy about it either. There was some of the executive board that wasn't, but once he said, of course, when you're a family-owned business, you know, the one vote gets all the votes. So, he was passionate about it, he cared about it. But it's kind of like I talked about earlier, the way we try to think of growing Chick-fil-A. I mean, you think about Chick-fil-A, we're like 1,800 restaurants. The end of the year will be 1,900 restaurants. That's all we are. McDonald's? In fact, I looked at this last week just to make sure I had my numbers right. 35,000 restaurants worldwide. In America, 14,627 restaurants as of last week. Okay? 14,1900. We're still a little person. So, great question. Any other questions? I like this walking around better too. Any other questions about Chick-fil-A? Well, there's one last thing I'd like to leave you with then. And I found this is a great way to communicate as a leader. And of course, I communicate with a lot of different people. I communicate with young people. I communicate with the adults we have there. I communicate with our leaders. Is storytelling. And if you haven't figured out in your business stories to tell, please do. You can sit down and write a 1 minute story. You can write a 2 minute story. You can write a 3 minute story. Whatever story you tell can have an impact in your life and the lives of the people you're trying to lead. I'll give you a perfect example. I was at Chapel Hill High School speaking the other day to seniors. And we at Chick-fil-A have been successful. There's no denying it. We've been very blessed. But I reminded them where we started. Okay? My wife and I got married in 1984. We had a home. The home didn't even have a bathroom. I had to build the bathroom home. We got married in October. We bought the house in May. That whole summer, I built a bathroom so we'd have a bathroom. Okay? The winter of 84, if you were here and you remember, was a very cold winter. Okay? We grew up, Riverdale, Georgia is where we're talking about. My wife and I are married. I can't afford the heat to heat the house, so we have a wood stove. So I split wood that whole winter. Okay? And when we can tell stories to young people like that, then they realize that I didn't go ask for help. I didn't go get a handout. I didn't moan and groan and gripe. It's all Judy and I had. It's all we could do. When you can tell stories like that that impact people's lives, you can make a difference. So have a story to tell. Like I said, it can be a 1 minute story, 2 minute story, any story to your people and to the people you're trying to influence, you can make a huge difference. So, we've come a long ways, and I've been very blessed. So, but that's what we had to do. So, thank you for your time. Thank you for inviting me, and thank you for being here.
I want to marry you.
Thank you, Mike. It's been our great pleasure to sit here and listen to you share these examples of leadership with us. Thank you. At this time, it is my great pleasure to invite the Leadership Douglas co-chairs for 2015 to come up here and to recognize our 2015 Leadership Douglas graduates. Breezy Staten, Breezy with the Douglas County Economic Development Authority, and Chad Benton with Gold's Gym.
This year's class was so much fun to work with. We had a great group of leaders here. Chad and I will admit that when we first picked the class, we didn't know a lot of people. So it was great that we got to, you know, we're pretty active, so we felt like we knew pretty much everybody. And then we see this group of names and we're like, wow, we know a handful of these guys. So it was exciting and just a great year to get to know everyone on a business and personal level. So I will say that when you see our slideshow, that is just a glimpse of the fun that we had and the relationships that were built. Chad and I wanted to do something a little special for the class so that you could get a taste of their individual personalities. So hopefully you won't think it's cheesy or you know, maybe kid-like. Okay. But if you do, oh well, they'll understand it. And that's what this day is about. It's for them. So we just hope that you will enjoy the little presentation we have. So, okay, so at this time, I would like to ask our Leadership Douglas Day Chairs to please stand. They are all listed in your program, but the Leadership Douglas program could not be the organization it is without these groups of people that plan each day. So if you were one of the day chairs, if you'll please stand and be recognized. And we would also like to say a sincere thanks to the Douglas County Parks and Recreation Department. They were our class t-shirt sponsor. We wanted to be a little extra this year and not just have one shirt, but two shirts, so that on days where we were a little more active, we could wear a team jersey. And instead of asking the class to pay for it, we got a sponsor, and the Douglas County Parks and Rec were more than happy to do that for us. So if Chad or Tracy is here, I'm not sure, they said they would try to make it. Anyhow, thank you to them. If you see them, tell them thanks. It's your turn, Chad.
Mm-hmm. The 2015 graduates you will meet momentarily were a phenomenal group of leaders. They challenged the teachers and each other and even completed two successful class service projects, Loving Hands Ministry and Youth Villages. Any one of them would be a successful addition to a community leadership position, so I hope the community boards are paying attention. As Breezy pointed out, we thought it'd be fun to give a little awards to each participant this year to show you a little insight into their amazing personalities of this amazing group that we had. So, graduates, as I call your name, come forward, please. Yes, you're first. The Gummy Bear Award is presented to Sheena Anderson with Regions Bank for always smiling and having a positive attitude. The Whoppers Award is presented to Zach Artis with the Douglasville Police Department. Because he always told the best stories.
He never said any names, though.
What's that? Never said any names, so you're all safe. Everybody's safe. The Hershey's Award is presented to Stephanie Bleakley with John Bleakley Ford. Uh-oh, did she say? For being kind and encouraging to everyone.
Thank you.
The Kit Kat Award is presented to Charles Branson, disability representative, because he does so much for our community and he deserves a break. The Carefree Award is presented to Rocky Clay with Edward Jones Investments. For always being so laid back and carefree. He's so carefree, he does not even care that he doesn't get the right candy.
They don't make that anymore.
The Mr. Goodbar Award is presented to Richard Coffey with IBM Corporation. Because simply, he's a good guy. The Rollo Award is presented to Andrew Dickinson with First Presbyterian Church. Because he is able to get along with everyone.
It must be the accent.
It must be the accent, that's right. The Three Musketeers Award is presented to Heather Garrison with Puckett EMS. For always pitching in when everyone needs her. The Butterfinger Award is presented to Davina Grace Hill with the Cultural Arts Council for her creative spirit. Not here today, but the Hot Tamales Award is presented to Rich Johnson with AT&T for always being quick on his feet. And he's not here because he had a baby, so. Yes, yeah. That's right.
His wife had a baby.
His wife had a baby. The Crunch Award is presented to Steve Jones with City TV for always coming through in crunch time. The Sweetheart Award is presented to Colleen Moffitt with the Douglas County Chamber. Very much self-explanatory, yes. The Starburst Award is presented to John Pinson with Douglasville First United Methodist Church. Because he is a shining star of positivity. Maybe it's because he's a preacher. I don't know. The Snickers Award is presented to Daryl Ray with Hughes Ray's Company. Because he's always making others laugh. The Mounds Award is presented to Lindsay Sargent with the Water and Sewer Authority. Because once you get to know her, she is mounds of fun to be around. So. The Jolly Rancher Award is presented to Tim Scott with the Douglas County School System. Just for always having a positive attitude. The Almond Joy Award is presented to Beverly Chatin with Cobb and Douglas Public Health for always spreading joy to everyone around her. The Junior Men's Award is presented to Odette Simmons with the American Red Cross. Because with her positive demeanor, she is meant to do great things. Yeah, that was a good one. The Dove Award is presented to Joel Slater with Harvester Christian Academy. Always keeping the peace. Yes. The Skittles Award is presented to Sylvester Toe with Georgia Power Company. For his big, colorful personality.
Thank you.
The Lifesaver Award is presented to Stephen Wilson with Harrelson Metals. Yay. No matter the situation, he was always the first to help. Last but not least, the Mentos Award, presented to Tonya Jackson with Ray Lynn, because she has grown into her leadership potential this year and she has demonstrated a strong potential to be mentors to others. She was selected to share the class comments on their year.
It's your turn. Y'all can all sit down.
I know. This is exciting. Out of all the people, I thought about the saying where it says, there's one universe, nine planets, 204 countries, 809 islands, seven seas, and over 7 billion people. And I, Tonya Jackson, had the privilege, the profound privilege, of meeting 22 people who would change my life. So thank you, Douglas County Chamber, Callie, Breezy, Chad, our day chairs, our respective employers, our program sponsors, for allowing us to set out not only to survive, but to thrive in Leadership Douglas and become the bravest class ever. I believe that there is no greater critic than self. Many times it's our own self-doubt and fears that often hold us back. The class of 2015 learned that anything is possible. 22 people overlooked stereotypes, we tossed aside assumptions, we crossed racial barriers, gender traditions, and stepped out of our comfort zones. Some of us discovered abilities we never realized we had. We learned to tap into our true potential and gathered the strength to pull the covers on some of our hidden talents, therefore propelling some of us to become zip-lining champions, skip riders, creative dancers, skillful drummers, and even sharp shooters. We overcame the fear of rejection, ridicule, and criticism sometimes we perceive in our own minds from our peers. We felt the fear and resolved to take chances anyway. We believed as a class we could do anything, so we did. We learned leadership is really not about titles, your status, or even your age. It's about one life influencing another. Our extroverts learned to step aside, and our introverts stepped up. We faced our fears and strived at every opportunity to say, "Put me in, coach, I'm ready." This class helped me face one of my biggest fears. When my father died from a 2-year struggle with lung cancer, the fear of how I would live without him was overwhelming. His death took me out of my comfort zone. It literally knocked me off my feet. But the support, the concern, and the compassion that was expressed by my classmates gave me the strength to continue to overcome my insecurities and all of my fears of living without him. It enabled me to pull myself together and forge confidently into my future. So I thank you for that. These past 9 months, we have experienced and learned a lot. So I encourage each of you, leadership class of 2015, to reach back and pull someone else up. Help people even when you know they can't even help you back. Don't just aspire to make a living, aspire to make a difference. Because all of us here wake up with the 3 C's of life: choice, chance, and change. We must all make a choice to take a chance to change lives, our lives, and change the lives of others. So when you wake up each day, realize that you don't have what it takes to sit back and just be an average person. You, and you were born for greatness in your own very way. Know that your life is about breaking your own limits, outgrowing yourself to live the best life you can. So I challenge each of you to be fearless in the pursuit of whatever sets your soul on fire. LD 2015, I, Tonya Jackson, think all of you are so very amazing. Thank you.
Thank you. Got nothing against the big town. Still hate seat enough to say, look who's in the big town. But my bed is in a small town. Oh, that's good enough for me. Well, I was born in a small town, and I can breathe in a small town. Stand up and walk out on me. Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I will try not to sing out of key. Yeah. Oh, baby, how do you all I need is my brother. I say I'm gonna get high. Tell no insane.
I can go next. I don't even know what to say here, y'all. All right, well, congratulations, obviously, to all of our graduates from the chamber. They have been so helpful, really, for the last 10 months. We will get a group photo, grads, at the end, so please don't go scurrying off and make sure and come up front. As the administrator of the Leadership Douglas program, I personally want to thank Breezy.
What if we don't want to graduate?
Okay, you started this. It's a very special class. And I have a new one starting tonight, so you have to graduate is the answer. Oh my gosh, at 4 o'clock we start the class of 2016, so let's try to finish this with some diplomacy, and you're crying too. Thank you, Chad. So as the administrator, or fondly referred to as the babysitter of Leadership Douglas, that's right, general manager. I want to personally thank Breezy and Chad for the outstanding job they did serving as co-chairs. I Actually, they were coaches. This year was training camp by John Gordon, a book we followed. So they were the coaches. They really got to know and love this group, and I think that they would actually tell you that they grew as leaders this year as much as they did the year they went through, if not more. We do have a small recognition item for each of you, and we want to thank you for the hard work, and you're standing closer to them than I am. Thanks. She's the shy one in the class.
Okay, say that again, okay? Say that again. But first of all, we have a gift that we're going to present at our party because we don't want to embarrass them. So, like a class gift.
I said it's a new car, and she said we're going to embarrass
them. We have a small gift of recognition for each of you. Please, we'll have first Mr. Chad Benton come forward.
Here, Chad.
And next, Ms. Breezy Straighten, please come forward. Serving as co-chairs for Leadership Douglas is a huge commitment for our volunteers, and I would like to, at this time, introduce the new co-chairs for the class of 2016. And they are Ms. Jennifer Moore with the Douglas County Board of Commissioners, our class of 2014. Jennifer. And Mr. Daniel Manny with the Water and Sewer Authority, class of 2012. Will you stand and be recognized? Good job, guys. Excellent work already. Thank you both very, very much.
Excuse me. We are hijacking the script now. So Chad and I would like to award two last awards. The first one is all year long. Will you hold up our beautiful trophy? It's so beautiful. They worked really hard on this. Each class, this trophy was awarded to a different team. I don't know where the top went. Oh, there it is. There we go. So additions were made throughout the year based on who won it. And then at the end of our last class, we did a vote anonymously to decide which class member would take this beautiful trophy home with them for the remainder of their life, to display very proudly on their mantle in their living room. And the class, this was almost a unanimous decision, but the class decided that this trophy would go home with the one and only Stephanie Bleakley. This program, the Leadership Douglas program, would not be nearly the program that it is without the one and only Miss Callie Boatwright. So we don't have a lot, and we wish we could give her this in real life. She is getting the 100 grand award because she truly deserves 100 grand for all the work and dedication she puts into this amazing program. But I hope you like the candy bar just as much.
Chad, how many power classes do I have to take to work off 100 grand?
You're good.
You said you
got to
show up first.
Hey! I'll see you there tonight. Okay. All right. Well, you just met our newest graduates, but over 25 years, we've developed an incredibly strong group of Leadership Douglas alumni who remain involved, as you can see by the room, in the organization. In fact, we have more paid active alumni supporting the program this year than any year before in its history. Would all of our Leadership Douglas alumni in the room please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Thank you, guys. As always, we involve our alumni in nominating and selecting the Leadership Douglas Founders Award recipient. The Founders Award is given to a Leadership Douglas alumni who has demonstrated the guiding principles of the organization through giving back to the community in a leadership capacity over time. I think you will agree that this year's winner is an excellent example of a community leader, and one you have seen provide so much support to so many organizations in our community. This individual has served on many community boards and is also a Leadership Douglas alumni. This person is always willing to provide community support when asked and is well known for developing many youth as he leads an excellent team at his own company in both of its two locations. Please join me in recognizing our probably surprised keynote speaker, since he hasn't been to this luncheon before and didn't know this is how we do it. 1992 Leadership Douglas alumni, Mr. Mike Moore, winner of the 2015 Leadership Douglas Founders Award. Mike's amazing. I don't have this planned, but and hopefully it doesn't backfire. If you have been donated or given or supported by Chick-fil-A in some way in this room, will you please raise your hand? Mike, turn around, please.
My pleasure.
Thank you from all of us. Now it is my pleasure to bring back up Breezy Strayton, who is also one of the leaders of our Young Professionals Connection, which funds the scholarships, and one of the judges for the Chamber Foundation Leadership Scholarships, who will present our scholarship winners, but not get the candy bars.
No.
Awesome.
I'm sure the scholarship winners want me to make sure I have those. Each year, the Chamber Foundation selects two scholarship recipients from the many applications received. This year, the Chamber Board added a third scholarship as a donation in honor of our monthly luncheon keynote speakers. These scholarships are selected based on academic performance, community service, an essay, and of course, demonstrated leadership. This is a very hard decision for our judges, and this year we had a record number of applicants for the three scholarships, so this is a tremendous honor. The winner of the inaugural Chamber Board Leadership Scholarship will attend Brigham Young University in the fall and major in dance. The recipient of $500 is Madison Brown from Airway Christian Academy. Madison. I'm sorry, it's pre-dentistry, not dance. It does say dance on this.
You're very welcome. Did you want a picture? Okay.
Yes. The Chamber Foundation Leadership Runner-Up will attend Kennesaw State University in the fall and major in accounting. The recipient of the $500 scholarship is Trish Jenkins from Alexander High School. Trish. It is now my great pleasure to introduce the Chamber Foundation Leadership Scholar and winner of a $1,000 scholarship. The winner is a young lady who is a senior in the International Baccalaureate Program at Douglas County High School and a Youth Leadership Douglas graduate. At her school, she is president of the Student Government Association and is actively involved in other school organizations, including National Honor Society, the Spanish and Science Honor Societies, and Beta Club. Outside of school, she works on biomedical research, is a member of the track and field team, and she enjoys serving the dance and media ministries at her church. As a minimum time member of AmeriCorps, she loves serving her community with the Red Cross, Youth Villages Inner Harbor Campus, and other local nonprofit organizations. In the future, She plans to concentrate in neurobiology at Harvard College, attend medical school, and pursue a career in either neurology or neurosurgery. I did hear she also turned down offers to Columbia and Yale when she chose Harvard. So full scholarships to those schools. So I think we have a future leader on our hands, guys. On behalf of the Chamber Foundation, please allow me to extend my personal heartfelt congratulations to Ms. Kayla Evans, the Chamber's 2015 Foundation Scholar. And just very quickly, the YPC had our cornhole tournament this past Sunday, and I appreciate everyone coming out and supporting that. We would not be able to offer these leadership scholarships without the participation of all the businesses and individuals who contribute their time and money to our annual cornhole tournament. It was a huge success. We don't know how much money we raised yet, but word on the street is we did very well. So thank you for everyone who came out and supported that endeavor.
Thank you, Breezy. Congratulations to our scholars and also to Mike Moore, who is a role model to all of us. And congratulations to all the recent graduates of the Leadership Douglas class. Just a quick announcement to the Leadership Douglas graduates and also the Foundation Scholarship recipients. Please don't forget that you have a group picture right up outside after the meeting. Thank you to Google for sponsoring today's luncheon, to Sam and Roscoe's for catering the luncheon, and to Greystone Power Corporation for their naming sponsorship and for their annual support. Thank you so much for being here. Have a great day.